have done 1,000 things in about 3 days. And I'm just enjoying sitting back and not having to prepare a sermon this week. When I found out that at first she was going to be able to come for a longer period of time, but she pastors 4 Methodist churches in the UK. And when she goes back, she was going to come for 2 months, but then she took a job in a high-security prison to be a chaplain in a high-security prison in England. And she's got to be back there for certain things, so she had to cut her trip short. So I've set her up to be in different churches and be in feeding programs in Bordentown, and she's been in Beverly. She's doing all that she can possibly do, attending minister's breakfast. We're eating a lot together. That's one thing that I would do. So let's welcome Naomi Kaiga.
I'm still amazed that you can invite me to study again after last week. But as I said last week, always blame the pastor. Because if anything doesn't go right, blame the pastor. And just what is happening in the UK today, they put the clock forward, 1 hour forward, so we are 5 hours behind them now, so it's around 4 o'clock there now. And also, it is Mothering Sunday in the UK, so all the churches are celebrating the women in their churches, they are getting chocolate or flowers, and I hope they'll keep some for me. I told them I'll not be there, but I want you to keep mine, some chocolate. At least the flowers might have dried by the time I get back. And also I've been seeing some misty calls from my daughters trying to wish me Happy Mother's Day. So so many mothers will be taken out for lunch, flowers. They will be spoiled today, and I want maybe my girls to remember I still need those gifts when I come back, even if I'm not there. I'm so pleased again to speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And as I said last week, my prayer is, Lord, always let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you. O Lord, our God. This morning we are thinking about the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd. When Pastor Kim asked me whether I can speak today, I have a weakness to say yes. Every time I don't pass an opportunity to preach. And one time my daughter told me that I talk too much. I told her, yeah. That's what I do for a living. So I took this opportunity to speak again, and I keep on saying, I hope I'll not empty your church before I leave this place. So honored to be here to speak about the Good Shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. When I was growing up back in Kenya, in the village, I and other kings, we were given the responsibility of looking after our father's flock. Most of the time, we could gather together with the different, boys and girls, and we look after the goats and other flocks together. You know, when I look back, I realize I grew up kind of a tomboy, and I used to fight a lot, and especially beat the boys who were not good to me. We had the responsibility of looking after this flock. We could scout and find out where we could find green grass, where we could find water, where we could find other stuff to care for the animals. We could do this probably the previous day so that when it comes in the morning, we just drive the flock there. We could make sure that the animals were well fed, they were well watered, they were well protected, and if anything threatened them, we were there to protected them. And although maybe we were small, we could not protect a lot, but we were prepared to do that. The flock didn't have to worry about what they were going to eat or the water they were going to have for that day. It was our responsibility as the shepherds, girls and boys, to look for the ring and to look for what they were going to eat, and also where they were going to rest without being disturbed. Theirs was just to eat and rest and look cute. It is our responsibility to worry. Like us, we have had the ones from the shepherd boy we read that earlier, who is writing from experience, saying that the Lord is my shepherd and I will lack nothing. David was writing this knowing what is the responsibility of a shepherd, because he was a shepherd himself. So he was talking from experience. And he was looking at all the things that he was doing, protecting, providing, being there and guiding the sheep. And he said, who does that for me? Who is there to protect me? Who is there to feed me? Who is there to guide me? Who is there to make sure that I am safe? I have enough to eat. He says, the Lord is the one who is my shepherd. And then we hear from John's gospel, who recites one of the greatest sayings of Jesus, I am. He says, I am. This says, does it say I was or I'll be? It is I am. And the English language says that is present tense. Now, I am to you now. Not what I was to you yesterday, not what I will be to you tomorrow. I am to you now. I am the good shepherd now. I am your protector now. I am your provider now. I am your help now. Whatever you need today, I am. So Jesus tells them, I am the good shepherd, the shepherd who lays down his life for you. That means the shepherd who will stand in your place, the shepherd who will look for what you need, the shepherd who will put his life in danger because of you. And we are thinking this time of Easter, this time of Lent and Easter is coming, we are thinking about what the shepherd took for us. He says, I am your shepherd, you are present, I am here to you. So David, who knows what a shepherd does, says, he is my shepherd. Jesus says, I am your shepherd. This fits together. David knows what it means to have someone who deeply cares for you, who deeply prepares for you, who watches out for you, and he says, Jesus says, I am that one. I am that one. The shepherd leans to green pastures. The servant put, you know, help us to lie down in green pastures, meaning still waters, meaning that he rests our souls. He rests and he restores us in guides in the right path. The shepherd protects as we walk through the dangers, the shadows of life. I preached in this text many times when I'm doing the funeral. You know, I've recited it. You know, and sometimes it sounds like a funeral psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, the funeral psalm. But if you look closely, it says that through life we walk through so many dark valleys. And now maybe in funeral we think, when I walk under the shadow of the valley of death. But we realize there are so many shadows we walk through. The shadows of loneliness, the shadows when we lose someone, the shadows when there is no one to love you. We walk through so many valleys in this life. And therefore it says, wherever you are, whatever valley you are walking through today, you know people who are walking through different kind of valleys. Valleys that are taking your health away, valleys where the families are breaking down, valleys when your friends have left you, valleys when you have lost someone in your life, through the dark valley of life. I would love to think that you'll walk through this life without any kind of valley. But no, real life says pain is part of life. Brokenness is part of life. These natty valleys are part of life. But hey ho, we don't walk by ourselves. We are never in that valley alone. We have the good shepherd walking with us. We can't fear. No matter what it feels like, sometimes you feel as if he is far away, but he says, my rod and his staff will comfort you. No matter what. You know, growing up, I thought my father was the greatest man in the world. He was the strongest, and there was nothing that could put us in danger as long as he was home. Actually, I felt so secure. I could do anything when my father was there. He was my hero. But as I grew up, I realized there are some things in need to know, and maybe he was not the strongest man in the world. Well, but that time it served with the purpose anyway. And I could remember one time I walked with him for a long distance, and I remember this journey, we were walking through some kind of bush and all that, and there was this big snake that, you know, it was, you know, these bushes. And you know what? My father killed it. It was very dangerous, but he killed it. I said, you see, you can't joke with my dad. He is there. And I didn't have to do anything. He protected me. I had faith in my father. We are reminded this morning, we have a father who is a shepherd who knows every bit of your story. I keep on telling the men in the prison, because they think, oh God, you can't love me because I have done A, B, C, D. And of course, what they have done is horrible things. But I remind them, you don't have even to explain to God what you have done. Because he was there. He saw it. He has been in your life all along. He has never left you. Yet, he loves you anyway. God who walks us in the valleys and the hills in the sandy time, he says, I am your shepherd. I know what you need. So John says that Jesus said, all my sheep, we are a sheep. They hear my voice. They understand me. They come and they follow me as I have laid my life for them. We are celebrating the good shepherd. The good shepherd who will never leave us alone in times when we go through life. He is there. He provides for us. He will walk with us. He will comfort us. He will protect us. We will hear his voice in the dead of the night. See, I know what you are going through. I know you by name. I know what you are experiencing. I know your weakness. I know your pain. And I am here for you. You are not alone. Don't you go through life like some people go through life without realizing they are loved. They are not only loved, but they are accepted. They are special. We have a good shepherd. If you don't remember anything else this morning, remember that Christ, the Lord, he is your shepherd. He has never left you. He will never leave you alone. And his words for you is, I have loved you with an everlasting love. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.